Okay, good morning students, welcome to our physics online class, and today we will be starting a new portion which is refraction of light. So first part of this lesson will be done as a slideshow presentation, as I am unable to go to school and record the class due to COVID-19 lockdown situation here. Welcome to the class. Okay, if you want to take notes, please do that as the lesson is going on, and you can listen very carefully to the slides. Okay, this chapter deals with the property of light, and the basic thing which we know about light is that light travels in a straight line. It travels in a straight line, and this property of light is called rectilinear propagation of light. That means light travels in a straight line, and due to this rectilinear propagation of light, it is able to reflect from a surface. Light rays reflect from a surface. Due to reflection of light ray, we are able to see things which are around us. So let's have a recap of what reflection is. So let's consider this black bar as a smooth polished surface. If a ray of light falls at an angle on that surface, that ray of light will be reflected back into the same medium, or it will bounce back into the same medium, and this phenomenon is known as a reflection of light. The bouncing back of light ray into the same medium after striking a surface is known as reflection of light. So today in this class we'll be learning about another property of light expressed by these pictures. So you are already familiar with pictures or incidents like this. Look at this pen. It's actually a straight pen. When we partially dip it in water, the half part or the part of that pen which is immersed in the water seems to be bent from the surface. But if you take it out, it's a straight road. So another example, look at that spoon inside the glass of water. That spoon seems to be broken at the surface, separating the water and air. And look at this third picture. There is an arrow mark which is pointing towards the right, kept at the back of the glass. But when we pour water into it, that arrow mark is facing in the opposite direction, that is towards the left. And all this happens due to the property of, or due to the phenomenon now called refraction of light. So we'll be learning about refraction of light in more detail in this chapter. You have learned about refraction in class 9. We'll be elaborating on what you have learned in class 9. So let's do a recap of what you already know. Let's consider that this green box is a glass block, and it is kept in the atmosphere. That means it is surrounded by air, and surely the top surface is air. And air is a medium through which light can travel, and glass is also a medium through which light can easily travel. So let's consider the separation between the two mediums be called PQ. It is the surface separating the two mediums, PQ. Now let's consider a light ray which is falling at an angle on the surface separating the two medium. It is falling at an angle, obliquely, it is falling obliquely. And the point at which the light ray falls, we can mark it as O. And that point O is called the point of incidence, and the light ray is called incident ray. And at the point of incidence, we draw a line perpendicular to the surface PQ, and this perpendicular is called normal. Normal is also perpendicular, and we name the normal as NN dash. What happens to this light ray? A small part of this light ray will be reflected back into air. A small part of this light ray will be reflected back into air, and here we can see it obeys the laws of reflection and it goes in the direction of C. But a major portion of this light will pass into the glass. A major portion of this light will pass into the glass. And we began this lesson by telling that light travels in a straight line. That's the rectilinear propagation of light. But we see that when light enters from one medium to another medium, it bends. The light ray will bend. Here in this case, when it is traveling from air to glass, it is bending towards the normal. It is bending towards the normal. And this is known as refraction of light. We'll define it. Before that, I'll introduce to you some more points. First one, look at that angle there. Angle formed between the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. Angle between the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection, and the angle between refracted ray and the normal is called angle of refraction. The incident ray, the reflected ray, and the refracted ray. Now let's define what is refraction. It's simply that bending is called refraction. So what is refraction? The bending of light ray when it passes obliquely from one transparent medium to another transparent medium is called refraction. So the only word which you have to remember here is obliquely. Obliquely means at an angle. It should not be coming through that normal line. If the light ray is coming through that normal line, the angle of incidence is zero. We need a value for angle of incidence. That means the light ray should be at an angle or obliquely. The bending of light ray when it passes obliquely from one transparent medium to another transparent medium is called refraction. Here air is a transparent medium, glass is a transparent medium. Now let's see what is medium. It's easy. A substance in which light travels is called a medium. Light can travel through air, light can travel through glass, light can travel through water, light can travel through alcohol, turpentine. Many examples are there in which light can travel. So all those things through which light travels is known as medium. And another important point remember is speed of light will be different for different mediums. So light does not travel at equal speeds in all mediums. Let's look at some examples. Three examples are given here: air, water, and glass. Look at the speed of air in look at the speed of light in air. It is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. We know that it's actually for vacuum. For air it will be little less than that of vacuum, and in vacuum light has the highest speed, and which we call as universal constant, and which we represent by the symbol C. Here we see that light travels fastest through air, and in the list the slowest medium for light propagation is glass. And the medium in which light travels the fastest is called rare medium. And if light travels slower through a medium, we call that medium to be denser. So rarer, denser, it's a comparative degree. So we use these terms when we compare one medium to another. For example, when we take air and water, light travels faster through air. So air is a rare medium and water will be a denser medium. But when we take water, when we compare water and glass, light travels faster in water and slower in glass. So water is a rare medium when it is compared to glass, which is a denser medium. Okay, I hope that point is clear to you. Now going to the next part, cause of refraction. We just now said that. What's the cause of refraction? This difference in speed of light in different medium. So refraction of light takes place when it travels from one media to another because the speed of light is different in two media. It's the difference in speed which causes refraction. Now we'll go to three main points which you have to remember. The first one is light ray traveling from an optically rare medium to an optically dense medium. The refracted ray bends towards the normal. So when we tell about density of a medium, it is not that density which we learn as the property of matter. the mass by volume density. It's not that density. This density is optical density, and it is for optical mediums or transparent mediums. If the light travels faster through a transparent medium, then that is a rare medium. If the speed of light is less when compared to another medium, then that medium is called a denser medium. So it is optical density, not the matter density. So we'll discuss these three points again, but let me tell you the second one. If light ray travels from a dense to rare, that is from example from water to air, if light is traveling from water to air, it will bend away from the normal. And finally, if the incident ray falls normally on the surface of a glass slab, then there is no bending of the ray of light and it goes straight through the mediums. Let's look at the pictures. First case, light traveling obliquely from rare to dense. So we already said that air is a rare medium when compared to glass, which is denser when compared to air. So look at the light ray. The light ray is coming, the incident ray is in the air. After striking the surface, it is bending inwards, it is bending towards the normal. It is bending towards the normal, therefore angle of refraction is less than angle of incidence. So this is the first point to remember. When light ray is traveling from rarer medium to denser medium, then the refracted ray bends towards the normal. Second case. Now look at the arrow marks of the light ray. So when you are drawing these pictures, remember it's very, very important that you mark the arrow marks. Now look at the arrow marks. The light ray is traveling from dense medium to a rare medium. At that time, the angle of incidence is less than the angle of refraction because the light ray is bending away from the normal. The light ray is bending away from the normal. Look at that part. The refracted ray is the angle of refraction is bigger than angle of incidence. This is the second case. And these cases can be asked in the exam. They may ask you to draw these figures. And this last one, the third case, when the light ray is falling normally on the surface. Normal means perpendicular. When the light ray is falling perpendicularly or normally on the surface, look at the angle marked there. The angle is 90 degree. That is not the angle of incidence. That 90 degree is not the angle of incidence. That 90 degree shows the angle at which the light ray is falling. The angle of incidence here is 0 degree, because normal and the incident ray are on the same line, so there is no angle between them. So angle of incidence in this picture, in this figure, is 0 degree, and what is shown there is that the angle compared to the surface of the glass air medium and the light ray. So what we see here is that the light ray passes through the surface separating the two mediums without any deviation. There is no deviation if the light ray is falling normally. That is the third point. So remember, I will go back and I will tell you once more. From rare to dense, bending towards the normal. From dense to rare, bending away from the normal. If the light ray is falling normally, then there is no deviation, or we can say there is no refraction. Now we have to study the laws of refraction of light. There are two laws of refraction. The first law of refraction, it is almost similar to the laws of reflection. That is, the here it is incident ray, the refracted ray, the normal at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. The incident ray, the refracted ray, and the normal at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. They are all in the same plane. Then, second law of refraction of light, it's also known as Snell's law. And Snell's law of refraction says the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant for a given pair of media. That is, if you take the sine of incidence, angle of incidence, and sine of angle of refraction and take a ratio between them or divide them, for all values of incidence, all values of angle of incidence, it will remain a constant. If you change the angle of incidence and take the readings again and again, we see that it will remain a constant. And this constant is called the refractive index for that given pair of medium. This constant is called refractive index for that given pair of medium. So we will go into detail about what is refractive index of a medium. So it's the ratio between sin I and sin r. The ratio between sin I and sin r is called the refractive index. If a ray of light is traveling from air to glass, that is rare to dense, then the ratio sin I by sin r is called refractive index of glass with respect to air. Remember how we call it? Light is traveling from air to glass, then it is the refractive index of glass. The light ray is traveling from air to glass, then it is refractive index of glass with respect to air. Then you can see a symbol over there which looks like a U with a long tail in the beginning part. That symbol is called mu, or we can use small n also for representing this refractive index. And remember, this refractive index is a ratio between similar quantities, and hence it does not have a unit. Okay, this much is the introduction for our next chapter, which is refraction of light. We'll be going into detail about each of the points and more additional things which we'll be learning in the coming days, and applications of refraction, how to solve certain problems, all those things will be dealt in the coming lessons. And I have given you a link for the questions below this video. Please go through the questions and answer it and send it to me. Thank you all.